in its assessment of current and evolving domestic and global macroeconomic and financial conditions, the Monetary Policy Committee observed that since its meeting in June, global growth has sustained pace, but it has become uneven. Risks to the outlook from volatile and elevated oil prices, mounting trade tensions, and tightening of financial conditions have increased. Inflation has edged up in several major advanced and emerging economies, driven by rising energy prices and the pass-through from respective currency volatility. Financial markets remain unsettled, and capital flows to emerging economies have declined, with their currencies depreciating against the firming US dollar. Instances of contagion have also occurred since April. On the domestic front, the Monetary Policy Committee took note of the rise in retail CPI inflation for the third consecutive month in June. Even though food inflation remained muted, other components recorded moderate to sharp price increases. Households reported an uptick in inflation expectations, while manufacturing and services firms indicated elevated input costs and wage growth in the organized sector remained firm. Even as inflation projections for Q2 have been revised marginally downwards vis-a-vis the June statement to 4.6%, projections for the second half of this fiscal year remain broadly unchanged at 4.8%, with risks evenly balanced. For the first time, the projection of inflation for Q1 for the next financial year, that is 2019-2020, has been given, and it is placed at 5%. Excluding the HRA impact, CPI inflation is projected at 4.4% in quarter two of this fiscal year, 4.7% to 4.8% in the second half of this fiscal year, and 5% in the first quarter of 2019-2020. In the view of the MPC, there are several risks to this outlook. The high volatility characterizing crude oil prices, financial turbulence in global financial markets, hardening of households' inflation expectations, and input pressures faced by corporations domestically. Moreover, any fiscal slippage at the center and or state levels could have adverse implications for the inflation outlook and could crowd out private investment going forward. There is considerable uncertainty around the full impact of the MSP changes on inflation, which will only resolve in the next several months once the price support schemes are implemented and rolled out across the commodities. While the statistical impact of the HRA revision by state governments can be looked through, it is important to be watchful for any second round impact on inflation. On the other hand, the MPC noted that the recent softening of commodity prices could contain input costs, while the reduction in GST rates could moderate inflation if there is a pass-through to retail consumers. In our assessment of the outlook for domestic economic activity, we observed that there is a gradual recovery of the southwest monsoon, but the sown area of kharif crops is lagging in relation to a year ago. Industrial growth strengthened in April-May 2018, and the output of 8 core industries accelerated in June. Non-food credit by banks is growing at about 13%. Capacity utilization in the manufacturing sector remains robust, and there is optimism on the outlook. Services sector activity appears to be picking up in a broad-based manner. Double-digit import growth in May and June pushed up the trade deficit. Foreign direct investment flows improved significantly in the first 2 months of 2018-19, while recently foreign portfolio investment outflows have been slowing. Looking ahead, the committee felt that the progress of the monsoon and a sharper than the usual increase in MSPs of kharif crops could boost rural demand by raising farmers' income. Investment activity remains broadly firm, and the pickup in foreign direct investment amidst buoyant domestic capital market conditions bodes well for prospects. Notwithstanding some tightening of financing conditions and rising trade tensions, GDP growth is projected at 7.4% for this fiscal year, as in the June statement. 7.5 to 7.6% in the first half of 2018-19 and 7.3-7.4% in the second half, with risks evenly balanced. The projection of GDP growth for the first quarter of 2019 is placed at 7.5%. In the assessment of the committee, uncertainty around domestic inflation needs to be carefully monitored in the coming months. In addition,